Welcome to Medical Dialogues. I'm Roshni. Let's look at today's top news. With face cover, IAS officer inspects UP's Firozabad Health Center. In a commendable move to address public grievances, Kriti Raj, an IAS officer and subdivisional magistrate of Firozabad, UP, conducted a surprise inspection at a government health center. Disguised as a patient, Raj uncovered various discrepancies including staff absenteeism, expired medication stocks and substandard hygiene practices. Expressing concern over the deteriorating quality of service, she emphasized the need for prompt action, signaling impending investigation and possible consequences for the health center officials. Visuals from the inspection showcased Raj's proactive approach, mingling with patients, scrutinizing medication stocks, and evaluating the facility's overall functioning. Health Ministry notifies National Dental Commission Rules 2024 in a gazette. The National Dental Commission Rules 2024, published by the Dental Education Section of the Union Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, detail the procedures for appointing members and office wearers of the commission, salaries and allowances, nomination process and other administrative matters. Medical colleges will now have to submit details of the villages adopted under Family Adoption Program on an MC portal. The NMC has mandated medical colleges offering MBBS courses to submit details of villages adopted under the Family Adoption Program on its portal. This decision was confirmed during a recent online meeting held on 12th of March. The Family Adoption Program aims to improve healthcare accessibility in rural areas by involving MBBS students in community outreach initiatives. The initiative was discussed in a paper authored by Dr. Aruna V. Vanikar and Dr. Vijendra Kumar, a board member. Published in the Indian Journal of Preventive and Social Medicine, the paper highlighted the significant rural population in India and the disparities in healthcare access. The PIL filed in the Bombay High Court challenges the constitutionality of the guidelines for intensive care unit admission and discharge criteria issued by the DGHS. The petitioner, the Medical Legal Society of India or the MLSI, argues that these guidelines violate constitutional rights and contravene a Supreme Court order from 24th of January last year. According to the PIL, the guidelines empower individuals or medical professionals to make decisions regarding life support withdrawal without the necessary formation of medical committees, posing a threat to patients' right to life and medical professionals' right to practice. The PIL also objects to provisions specifying which patients should not be admitted to the ICU and aspects of the ICU discharge criteria, arguing that such decisions should involve medical, legal, and administrative authorities as outlined in the Supreme Court order. That's all for today. Stay tuned to Medical Dialogues for more updates.
Never miss a medical update from Medical Dialogues. Like, subscribe, and press the bell icon.